cockpit review, and this time it is Man Cave Edition. Today's video is brought to you by GameGlass. GameGlass allows you to take control of your ship from a tablet or phone. Not only that, but you also get on-screen information about your ship, your targets, and the world around you. So gone are the days where you have no more room for your key bindings, or you have to alt-tab out of the game to look up market data. On top of that, GameGlass also works with Star Citizens, so follow the link in the video description and try GameGlass for free. If you like it and want more shards and features, you can buy them individually, or you can subscribe to GlassPass. Use offer code DTEA on checkout and get 5% off your first purchase. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another cockpit review. And this time we're going to go Man Cave Edition. So I'm going to be trying to focus on submissions from you guys where you've sent in places where we can see like the whole room and where the whole thing is decked out just for one purpose, which will often be gaming in this situation here. And as always, if you want your own setup featured, just do send it to me. It doesn't matter if it's just a laptop in a corner on a shelf, or if it's like something you've been building over many years, like a full room with custom lighting and everything. Send it in. I try to get a variety of cockpits in, so send it to downtoearthastronomy@gmail.com. I'll be sure to post the email in the description. And we're going to start with this one, who comes from Chris. I don't really know a whole lot about it. His email was very brief, so we're just going to try to deduct as much as we can from the setup. First of all, of course, we noticed he has, I believe these are the Monster Tech chair mounts. We have what looks like the joystick from a Warthog over here on one side. And then we have another Thrustmaster one over here. So he's running a dual stick setup, which is quite uncommon. Can see a stream deck over here, of course. Probably either he's streaming, maybe we'll see that later if he has some other streaming gear set up, or it could just be an input device. But that's obviously not the only setup he has. We can see there's another chair over here, and that looks like a chair with built-in speakers into it. I wonder if it has like vibration in it as well. The brake, I believe, gear shift probably here. We've got a steering wheel. And it looks like, I'm not sure, but it looks like it's running off a console. I'm not sure if all this works with console, how that works. But at least looks like there's some kind of console back here. Some kind of Xbox with all the green, that would be my guess. Okay, here we get a view from the other side. We can see, first of all, that he is also playing Star Citizen, as we can see that he's playing right now. And we can now see that he's also running a dual tablet with GameGlass on, which is, again, a really nice way. So it seems like this is very sparsely populated right now. So this may just be like a general purpose, like easy shortcut kind of deal, since I would assume he's going to have most of his input covered by the tablets here. And on this one now, we can also see he has a little side table here, where of course he has the throttle from the Warthog. So he does run dual stick and throttle, plus that little extra like side keyboard there that we often see people use, plus all the the tablets and the stream deck, and of course keyboard if you really want anything else. I don't think I see any specific streaming equipment, so I think this is just a gaming rig. And the final picture here, this is amazing. Look at that. Some kind of arcade simulator. I'm not sure. I'm really not into retro gaming, and I'm not sure if this is like a known thing. It looks like it's car speakers that's been installed up here, and obviously it's running some kind of emulator, but having a dedicated arcade machine in your man cave, that's next level. You don't see that too often. That's an awesome setup, and thanks a lot for sending that in. Next up, we have one that I actually got sent quite a while ago, and I've been wanting to feature it for a while because it puzzles me a little bit. This is from Commander Philicus, and he writes in his email that he is a VR enthusiast. He plays solely in VR Valve Index, as we can see here, and he calls it a mobile setup, and it is quite interesting. We have this, what looks like a makeshift table, where he has his X-52, he has a racing wheel, he has a Secret Lab chair. He says that he got that after seeing me recommend it in some of the videos, so that's nice to see. Now, here is the part that confuses me, and that is, it seems that he has the green screen in front of him, which I don't understand, unless he has a camera behind him, because he must have a camera somewhere, but I don't think that I managed to spot it, but it could be here, but like above the frame, so just out of frame. There could be a camera pointing down if you want a camera from behind him. Also, I noticed this one, there's some markers on the floor. I wonder if that has something to do with, like, maybe it is if you do those, you know, when you put yourself into the game in like some Beat Saber thing. I don't know if it's something like that. He does say that the intention with this is to make it light, easy to move around so that he can get it out of the way if you want to play standing VR games, which makes sense then with a small, relatively light table, so it's easy to just move around and have everything mounted in one place. You can just move it out of the way. But overall, I would love if any of you guys in the chat know why you would put the green screen in front of you. I'm assuming it has something to do with the markers on the floor as well. Oh, hold on, I just noticed here at the end that he actually mounted or built the chairs without the armrests on, which I guess makes sense in a VR setup to have the without armrests. I should just notice that now. Anyway, thanks for sending that in as well. Now, the next one here, as we can clearly see, says Man Cave on the door. And this comes from Commander Jack in the Box, I think, who plays on Xbox. And this is probably the smallest Man Cave that I have seen. So just take a look at this. That's it. It's basically a cupboard that he is playing in. At first I was really confused because he's playing on Xbox. We can see it up here. He has that. We've seen this in a few situations. This actually looks like one of those stands you use for like a keyboard to fold out. But he has some kind of fold out thing here. At first I was confused, like, where's the screen? It's right here. Right here on the side. We get a few more close-ups of the setup here. We can see his Xbox sitting here on the shelf above him. He has his of course Xbox HOTAS mounted to the chair. There's some speakers mounted to the wall, it seems. Tablet probably has a secondary screen, so you have, you know, for an hour and all that good stuff. There we can actually see the monitor right here. This looks like it's on an arm, so I assume that he goes in, sits in the chair, and then folds out the arm so that the screen is then in front of him. Now, I can imagine, you can see it's actually next to the water heater, that room can get quite hot. So I would imagine that you would probably play with the door open. Otherwise, I would assume it would be very, very, very hot in there. I don't know how much heat an Xbox is putting out, but just sitting in such a small room for an extended period of time, I could see oxygen becoming an issue. So I hope you're playing with the door open. But that is a very, very effective use of space. And I definitely like the ingenuity. I mean, who comes up with just putting a gaming setup inside your utility closet? I like that. And nice to see even the smallest spaces can be turned into a man cave. So there's really no excuses out there. Next up, we have the setup from Exodium on PlayStation. I hope I pronounced that right. And definitely another man cave setup. First of all, what we see here is actually two monitors. We have a ultra wide here at the top, a very, very wide, I think it's actually double width, where he's running Elite. And then there's a second screen down here, bigger one. I'm a little confused why you're putting the game up there. I'll probably be playing on the main screen, but I guess the wider field of view is nice. I don't know. We get the wide shot here. We can see, again, relatively confined space, posters everywhere. There's pretty much no wall visible. And we can see he is watching, looks like he either waiting for a live stream or watching a VOD of the live stream. Looks like he got what looks like a lumbar support pillow that he uses as a footrest. By the way, if you haven't tried this yet to have a footrest when you're playing, it is so nice. I used to have an old chair where I took the armrest and the back off, so it was just the seat itself, lowered down as low it would go, and then have that under the desk as a footrest. So nice, until the bunnies decide to eat it. There are speakers everywhere. He does mention that he has speakers everywhere. I don't know how many of them are hooked up, because it seems that looks like another console over there, if I'm not mistaken. And then he has the PlayStation HOTAS that it looks like he's just, because it's a very wide chair, and it looks like he's just putting that on, resting that on the chair. I would feel that way it might be a little unstable, that it's just sitting there on a soft surface. I'm not sure. But, I mean, if it works. He said he also mounted this on the table. He has this, like, car phone holder where he puts his phone, and then he can have, like, Inaura and all that kind of stuff. But definitely fun setup and an interesting combination with the with the main TV screen here, at least TV size screen, and then the ultra wide at the top, which seems to be his console screen, and then this one might be hooked up to a computer somewhere, I would guess. Next, we have the setup from Commander Olenex, I think, okay, that's pronouncing that right. Again, I might butcher this. And this, as it says, is basically a whole room where he set it up as a miniature land center, so you can have the whole squad come over and they can all bring their HOTAS. But anyway, we can see here he is rocking a X-52, relatively wide monitor again here, and then there's just basically gaming station. There's one here, there's one over here. This looks like a workstation maybe as well, with a dual monitor and then the TV above. So maybe there's like one for gaming, one for work. And as we go, we can see there's just basically there's just workstation or gaming stations all along the wall. So I count like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 individual stations where you can sit and play. And we get a little closer look. Actually, this is a dual monitor setup. Interesting with the dual monitors being split evenly. So he's probably running Elite on both with a line down the middle. And not sure if the PC, but at least he has a little Star Trek emblem here on the front of the case. But I included this because I thought it's so nice to see people actually making a man cave setup, a gaming room setup that is designed for just having the whole squad come over and play together. Used to do that like years ago with my buddies when we played EVE Online, come over and just sit and mine a whole evening. Maybe if some of these stations won't have seen too much use with everything going on, but let's hope they will see some action again soon. So those were the cockpits I decided to feature in this iteration of cockpit review. As I said at the beginning, do send in, even though I do have a huge backlog of cockpits to look at, I always want more, always want more options. So do send in your own cockpits if you want it featured on the channel in a future video. And of course, if you want more cockpit reviews like this, go down and hit the subscribe button. Thanks a lot for watching, and until next time, I will see you guys in space.